Welcome back to Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA. Today's episode, powered by Perfect Sports Nutrition, is your guide to body punches. Today's episode, we're gonna get into the details of body punches. And I always talk about body punches being a very valuable part when it comes to combat sports. And lately, the biggest reference we have is the UFC. And in my mind, guys do not hit the body enough, whether it's big gloves or small gloves. So this video, I'm gonna kind of break down body punching for you. How to use it, how to set it up, the different types of strikes, and how to do it without getting hurt. Okay, so let's get into the details of today's episode. The first thing when talking about body punches is how to set it up. Now, why is that important? One, I need to know about their elbow position, right? Because if someone's fighting with their elbows down, I can't attack the liver and they're good at blocking. So I need to set it up. The other thing I need to be careful of is if I'm leading with a body shot, it leaves my face wide open to get countered. People always talk about that with the uppercut. If I lead with an uppercut, my face is the first thing that's exposed so you can get caught. So, tip one, when getting into the guide of body punching, it's important to set them up. Now, how do you set them up? Many different ways, and you can use your kicks if you really wanted to, feinting, but I'm gonna get into the basics. So the main thing I need to be aware of is the elbow position. So the first thing I like to use when setting up body punches are probing straight punches. By me being here, probing the hands, I'm kind of just hitting the eyes. I'm punching even up a little bit to force the elbows up. Now, once their elbow position is up, now I have different options to attack the body, right? So that's one of the ways. The other thing you can do on top of probing is actually hit power shots to the head, okay? So what does that mean? If I'm just probing, Matt's a little bit more relaxed to maybe use a parry to move his feet, so it's hard for me to reach for it, right? So by throwing power shots to the head, it forces them to block. If you really focus on a left hook, that is my personal favorite, right? So if I come here and I maybe slap, boom, I hit a hard hook. He has to defend by covering his head, right? So what does this do for me now? It lets me rip the body, it opens up, right? So now I safely entered to the body because he had to protect his head. Now the same thing could be true with a 1-2. So if I sit here and I go boom, boom, hard 1-2, right? He has to block. So this gave me the option now to rip this body in any direction I want, okay? So that's the first thing. You can use a probing shot. Okay, singles, doubles, flashing the eyes, ding, ding, ding. You know, get them thinking here. As soon as the elbows come up, rip that body. The second way is those power shots, right? Ideally, I'm telling you, I love those big power hooks to the head. And a lot of the times you can even hook here, and sometimes I even hold them as frames, you know? I can frame and hit here. I can punch here, use this frame, and then attack the body, right? I can even kick off of it. But it's all about punching and getting in. So probing punches versus power shots to the head are all gonna help you hit that body more successfully. Now, the second thing we're gonna get into is the type of shots that you can throw. Now, when attacking the body, most people automatically think about the liver hook, right? So the first thing you'll notice is I wanna go here, attack the liver with my left hook. Now, what you need to do though, is understand that there are different punches you can throw. And when I talk about body punching, there's three main types of punches you're gonna focus on. Now, the obvious one is the straight punch to the body. So same thing, even if I'm probing upstairs, here, get elbow up, now I drop this, boom, right down to my solar plexus. Now, there's ways to throw that body punch. And the main thing I'm gonna tell you the big difference is when a lot of people throw the body punch, the straight, they focus on sitting down, okay? Which to me is more like a karate style hit to the body, and I don't necessarily love it. When I teach the straight to the body, I teach getting up on my back calf. This way, when the punch comes down, I get weight coming down on that solar plexus. So I like that style more than the sit down. Also, if I sit down here, it's harder for me to kick off of this position. So I'd rather be here, and then I can quickly switch off and throw my kicks if I need to, okay? So that's the way I like to crack the body. But point one, set them up properly, okay? Make sure you get in and make sure you set them up with the straight punches. Now, the inside work, okay? The second two punches we talk about, and one's called a round punch to the body, your traditional hook, and the other one is called a shovel punch. So I'll just show from this reference, rounder hooks versus shovel. So when I shovel, you see how it's almost like an uppercut, but it just shovels to the body. So shovel punch versus round. Now, they both seem similar. You're both attacking the body with some sort of round punch. But the punch depends on the elbow position. If I go here and I go throw a shovel punch, boom, Matt reacts by bringing the elbow in. That's how he has to block, right? He comes in. So if I shovel here, then my next one, I'm gonna come around and rip the body, right? So depending on where the elbow is, I throw. So when I'm playing my head-to-head boxing, I might just tap in with shovels and then rip, rip, rip. And then what does Matt do? Matt reacts by opening wide. And then I rip, rip, and then I rip in the shovel, okay? So I'm mixing round to shovel depending on how Matt or my opponent is defending with his elbows. He opens it up, okay? So that is the one thing you need to really be careful of. And understand the types of body position, all determined on where the elbow is. Now, the third key point to body punching is you can't just stop at the body. You did this work with a beautiful setup. Setting, maybe throw a hard one. I come inside, mix in my punches, and then I stop, okay? What happens in fighting when one opponent stops? The other person comes back and he counters. Big mistake. So how do I avoid getting countered to the head when I attack the body, right? So here at Bazooka Kickboxing, and it was really ingrained in me from the early parts of my career, head, body, head. So the first head shot is the setup. The second is the body shot that we're working on. Then you go back to the head. By putting the focus and punching the head again, Matt has to defend it, which now means I can exit safely without him having to punch me. So some of my favorite combinations would be if I hit here, boom, boom, I hit the head and I could move now, right? So by finishing to the head, boom, 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 I can hit, keep him pinned and now move. So mixing up that last part to the head not only lets you exit safely, it defends from the counter, but you invested in level changing, which ultimately could lead to a better chance of getting a knockout. To get the head, right? The number one thing, the most valuable part of anybody is gonna be the head. So they protect it, they move it, they hide it. So it opens the body. If I need to get to the head, right? If Matt's so protected here, I could waste so much energy and keep punching there, which is what we see a lot, even in the UFC. Way too much we see people holding the head. One of the biggest reference fights I watched recently was Wonderboy Thompson versus Gilbert Burns. Wonderboy did not attack the body at all. Gilbert Burns had the highest shell ever, and he could have mixed front kicks, side kicks to the body more, punches to the body. Wasn't used enough, even at the highest level. So make sure you go head, body, head, okay? So when you go attack, finish, go strong, and you're going to be as safe as possible, okay? Now, another key point we have to get into is angles, okay? Not, you don't necessarily need to sit here and go head to head all the time. You have to create angles. So even though I'm throwing my probes, I might create a quick angle to come off and attack the body. So here I can step off this way and hit the body. So using little subtle angles are gonna help you. Now, one of my favorite body punches is the left hook. I'm a level changer with my left hook. So when I sit in the pocket, I'll go head, head, body, body, head, head, body. So I keep mixing in so my opponent never knows. But while I'm throwing these hooks a lot of times, you notice my foot position. As I'm hooking, I slowly kind of angle to this position. So I slowly angled out to my left, and now I can come back upstairs on a better angle, right? Same thing if I'm here. If I'm punching here, I might come off here. I'm more safe here attacking on this angle, which I call a T stance, right? His feet and my feet make the letter T. Now from this position, I could be more effective punching through his guard, and I could mix the body and be more successful. So mixing in little angles is very important. Now, even with the angles, remember, angles can mean footwork, angle can mean the punch. So even when I'm setting up the big punches, I'm creating an angle. I'm slowing and then boom, mix in that shot. I can come in here, boom, step off, create attacks from here, right? So that head, body, head concept will be more successful if you take subtle and little angles with your feet. Now, the fifth and final point we're gonna talk about is Something that's not used. I mentioned body punches aren't used enough when it comes in fighting. But, okay, using it as a counter, right, is used even less. So a lot of times when we do see good body work, it's maybe that head-body-head with a combination or something fun. But the idea of countering to the body is very high level, and you tend to see it more in just strictly boxing. But in kickboxing and, you know, MMA, it can be used. So what does that mean? So the idea is, if Matt throws a punch, say he throws the classic right hand, and I'm going to slip. So instead of slipping and always attacking the head, right, slipping here, boom, and attacking the body. He throws a jab, I can come in here and then attack upstairs. So the idea of attacking the body as a counter, he throws a straight, boom, I can come here, then come upstairs and go back, right? So the idea of attacking is so important to the body. Now, the favorite way I would say using this concept is versus hooks, right? So it doesn't matter if Matt throws a lead hook, I can block here, I counter to the body. He throws the other side, boom, block here, counter to the body, and then I can go upstairs, right? So that is one of the ways. You can slip, I can pull, I can parry and counter. But focus on countering to the body. A lot of times, everyone knows the head. But if you counter to the body first and then go back upstairs, you're messing with the level changes and you're gonna hit that head more successfully, okay? So that is your basic guide to understanding body punches, okay? Just remember those key little factors. The setup is very important. Probes, power shots, get them to protect their head and then hit the body. But remember the point, go back to the head so you can enter, exit safely, right? And be more strategic. Make sure you take subtle angles so you can get back to the head and get better knockouts from that angle. And guess what? You drain their gas tank, you hurt them, you make them think of a different level. So many good things happen from just being able to mix the body. And that's the first thing you'll notice. If someone is inexperienced in striking, the first thing you'll notice is, one, they probably don't kick much, they only box, right? And the second thing is, they don't use the body strike. So that's one way to pick up on an inexperienced striker, all right? So I hope you enjoyed today's episode on body punching. Keep liking, subscribing, hit the notification bell, and make sure you support the channel sponsors. We have Perfect Sports Nutrition, Bazooka 20 in the link description below. We'll get you 20% off your supplements. Hayabusa Fight for all of the sick gear that I wear in all of my videos, also linked in the description. And then you have BazookaShop.com for your Bazooka gear. And finally, BazookaTraining.com is where you get lessons taught by me. I teach home workouts, tutorials, bag workouts, sparring drills. So if you enjoy these videos and these lessons I teach here, head over to bazookatraining.com for $9.99 US per month. You get the extension of these videos. Me teaching drills, how I put them in concepts, whether you're a coach even watching, my videos will help you be a better coach as well as a better athlete. All right, we'll see you next time here at Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA. Welcome to Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA Online Training. I'm Bazooka Joe Veltellini, the owner here at Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA. Over the past year, I've designed and created a website to teach Bazooka curriculum at home and across the world. The purpose of this website is for you to, one, hit your fitness and health goals, all while learning world-class martial arts instruction from me. The beautiful thing about this website, it's geared for all levels. So if you're learning martial arts for the first time as a beginner, we help you progress into the bigger stages. And if you're a pro fighter, guess what? We have different fight concepts for you to improve your tool set and your skills in the ring or cage. As the fastest rising kickboxing world champion and a lifelong martial artist with over 30 years of experience, I've been able to combine my passion for martial arts and teaching to create this website. This website's gonna give you some of the tricks, secrets, and inside look at some of the training I use to win my world title. Once you subscribe to this site, you're gonna be getting weekly training videos and tutorials that you can do from anywhere. The sections are broken up into three parts. The first is bag workout. So if you have a bag at home or at your gym, you can use these workouts to supplement your training. The second is at-home workouts. A lot of us don't have the room for a bag or a bag in general, so these workouts are for no equipment needed and you can do them anywhere. And finally, the tutorial section. If you're having any problems with a specific technique or fight concept that's covered in any of the workouts, go to the tutorial section, learn the technique, and then go back to the workout, and this time, do it with proper technique. One of the added benefits once you subscribe is the forum section where you can get a more personalized experience where you can ask questions and I'll be able to go in there and answer them. It's all about building a team and a community of martial artists helping each other grow. So subscribe now to get access to all the videos plus more so you can be part of the squad here at Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA.